Well, I got to tell you, waking up this morning to the information that came out on the mainstream media is just chilling to the very core. First of all, because I predicted to the T that the mainstream media and the Democrats would once again scream Russia collusion. And this is exactly what is happening right now. If you don't already know, Tim Pool, Dave Rubin, Benny Johnson, Lauren Southern, all these conservative media, well, the DOJ is stating that they have allegedly, keyword there, been tricked into $10 million Russia influence campaign. And what's interesting about this whole thing is, number one, I predicted it, right? They're kind of, it's like clockwork with these people. They play the same games and they do the same thing. And they always give you hints about what they're going to do. In fact, there's two major things that happened before this information came out, and one big thing that happened shortly thereafter. And I can't help but put the puzzle pieces together and say, are these things actually linked? Because I do believe that it's a possibility to, well, shall we say, distract the audience from what's really going on. And hey, make these conservative commentators look like Russians so nobody listens to them. And coincidentally, they support good old-fashioned Donald J. Trump, you know, the most hated man in the world by the Democrats that have left a lot of Democrats with, shall we say, Trump derangement syndrome. Now, I've got a lot to say about this. And the truth of the matter is I'm very shaken by this whole thing because it really screams that they will stop at nothing to accomplish their agenda. And now we have this entire case happening. But let me just talk about first what happened prior to that. That is key to everything. And the first thing I want to show you here is this article. This happened, by the way, on September 3rd. This came out just before the new revelation about Tim Pool and the others. But it's former aide to two New York governors is charged with being an agent of the Chinese government. And by the way, this is with Governor Hochul. A former aide to two New York governors was charged Tuesday with acting as an illegal agent of the Chinese government who used her state position to subtly advance Beijing's agenda in exchange for financial benefits worth millions of dollars. And of course, that was linked to Governor Kathy Hochul there. So her chief of staff. Interesting, right? Holy moly, we can't find out about this. Put a news source out there and let's distract the story immediately. Not only that, but this bit of information is interesting with Tim Pool, right? And the mainstream media is like, fake news. Well, whatever. Tim Pool actually threatened to, well, take action against Kamala Harris. He says, hey, we're going to sue you guys. And he's going to sue them over some information that he claims is untrue, which Kamala Harris said Trump operatives say their Project 2025 plan is to give Trump total unchecked legal power so they can jail and execute those who don't support Trump if he wins. And she plays that clip of Tim Pool there. But he says, hey, you're lying about me. You're not being honest. I'm going to take you to court. And then bang, right after that, this information comes out that, well, Tim Pool and others may have done something. In fact, there's actually one more piece of the story that I want to share with you that happened just before that as well. I should have said three things. It would have been more accurate. But before I do, I want to give a quick shout out to my sponsor, LisaHavenGold.com. Look, if you're ready to power up your retirement in 2024, you're going to want to check them out. Silver is about to shine brighter than ever before. And by the way, all the solar panels out there need a little bit of silver paste to work. So guess what? Silver is exploding right now. It's doubling every 3 years, and it's set to light up the world by 2035. That is why you want to check out a silver IRA or even a gold IRA, but go to LisaHavenGold.com, fill out that information, click get it now, and they're going to send you a free gold and silver investment guide on how to do stuff like that. Not only that, also, I want to encourage you to give them a call at 1-877-646-5347 and talk to one of their special agents. And right now, they are giving away up to 10 of these 1 ounce silver coins here, up to 10 of those, or an American flag bar, a 10 ounce American silver flag bar with any qualified agent. account. So check it out. If you want more information on that, click that more button or click the link in the description box below. And by the way, there's always a risk to investing. There's never a guarantee. All right. So let's get into this third thing that happened just before the information came out about Tim Pool and the others. How about this? And let me go back, actually. I'm going to go back to 2016 before I share this next one, because it's a repeat, right? It's a repeat of some things that have happened. In 2016, we got this bombshell from the FBI, and this is on the Intelligencer. Final October surprise reveals FBI is probing Trump's alleged Russian ties. Notice the date on that, November 1st, 2016. Let's fast forward to this one as well. And this happened in 2023. They finally told us the truth. Hey, it was all a hoax. We weren't exactly honest about Trump colluding with Russia. Here we have USA Today. Trump was right. Russia collusion was a hoax. Good luck regaining the public's trust. Now let's fast forward to 2024, right before the election. Yet again, this information came out just before, or shall I say, around the same time as the Tim Pool and other conservative information with Russia. U.S. accuses Russia of 2024 election interference. In fact, CNN put it this way. Biden administration announces major actions to tackle Russian efforts to influence 2024. It's like freaking reading a book. It's the same damn play every single year. And you can see this was just published September 4th, 2024. Coincidentally, what came out in the very same day, September 4th, this little nugget right here. Russian money was funneled to right-wing creators through a pro-Trump media outlet, prosecutors say. And this is on NBC News. Dun, 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 dun. Here we go again. I remember going through something very similar, you know, the first time around and 2016, when they were talking about the ties with Donald J. Trump and Russia collusion that turned out not to be true, and the Steve dossier, the Christopher Steele dossier that was just junk and a lie. Here we are. And you know what's interesting is I predicted this exact thing would happen, and it is. Now, to give you a little bit more information on what's going on with Tim Pool and the others, I've pulled this up on Zero Hedge. Popular conservatives allegedly, and that's the key word that we have to pay attention to here, were tricked into 10 million Russian influence campaign, according to the DOJ. Now, let me hit the pause button. We're talking about the same DOJ here that was in power then. Lisa Monaco, Christopher Wray, Merrick Garland, all the same players that were involved in some of this Russian hoax, now spewing the exact same thing and claiming allegedly. I can't help but think that there's a pattern here. There's a pattern here. And quite frankly, I'm not going to accuse anyone of anything either direction, because, hey, let's just put it out there. I want to see the freaking evidence. And until Christopher Wray and the others can produce that, keep your dang mouth shut. I want to see the facts. And so far, they've shown no facts. They just throw out this little sealed indictment, throw it out there and be like, oh, this is what we have done. I want to see the evidence. I want to see the proof. And they're not providing it. So please keep that in mind. I can't help but ask the question that maybe this is just another game from the FBI and DOJ, like they did the first time when they tried to accuse Trump. And look here, let me also be honest. I told you guys that they would do this to conservatives. I told you, I warned you. I said they would use the DOJ, they would use the FBI, and they would use the IRS. That's how they're going to get some of the other smaller people, right? But anyway, let's go back to this article so you get the drift of a little bit of what's going on, because they give a good assessment of that. The DOJ has accused several conservative influencers of, key word here, unwittingly. In other words, they had no idea about it. That's the key. Working for a Kremlin-funded media outlet. A federal indictment unsealed on Wednesday alleges that a Tennessee-based media company, later identified as Tenet Media, which they have a YouTube channel, right, received nearly $10 million from employees of Russian state-backed media, RT, Russia Today, as part of a scheme to create and distribute content to U.S. audiences with hidden Russian government messaging. It goes on. The DOJ claims that RT and two of its employees, Kostya and Elena Lina, right, worked to funnel money to Tenet Media as part of a series of covert projects aimed at shaping narratives within the Western audiences. The indictment specifically notes that the influencers, including Tim Pool, Benny Johnson, Dave Rubin, and Lauren Southern, had no idea, that's the key, that they were taking Russian money and were deceived. It says that in the indictment, right? And I've read the indictment. I know exactly what it says. It does say that. They were told by Tenet founder Lauren Shen, who allegedly knew the true source of the funds, that the money was from a wealthy private investor named Edgar Gorian. And I'm probably butchering that name, but I could care less right now. At least one of the influencers asked for a profile on Gregorian before signing a contract. And they were given a fabricated one-page profile. That is what the DOJ is claiming. And here's the statement that it says they wanted to see it moving forward. And here's reportedly the fake profile that was given to them. And you can see nothing really on there about Russia or anything to that level. But that's the fake profile that they were given. But it goes on to state that this was apparently sufficient, okay? The fake profile was sufficient for them, as two of the commentators believed to be Tim Pool and Benny Johnson signed contracts which paid Pool $100,000 per podcast. That's a lot. While Johnson was paid $400,000 per month plus a $100,000 signing on bonus for 4 weeks for four weekly videos. So you can see the statement there that is on the indictment there as well. And that's kind of it. I think that's kind of where I wanted. But here is the actual indictment itself. You can see it's got all kind of the information today that I just spoke about. I'm not going to reread it because it's basically the same thing. Here it talks about what they're kind of being accused of to the tune of $10 million, and you can see and how they funneled it through shell companies. And it also goes on to state here that the founders, right, worked together to mask U.S. companies' true source of funding. In other words, those who founded it, those who brought in Tim Pool and the others, masked it from them. In other words, hid the idea of who the guy actually was. So there's the entire kind of indictment of what's going on. So again, I'm going to say, I want more facts and I want more information because this smells a lot like what happened again in 2016. It really does. Now, Tim Pool has put out a statement in regards to that. He said, my statement regarding allegations and the DOJ indictment. Should these allegations prove true, I, as well as other personalities and commentators, were deceived and are victims. I can't speak for anyone else at the company as to what they do or what they are instructed. The Culture War podcast was licensed by Tenet Media. It existed well before any license agreement with Tenet, and it will continue to exist after any such agreement expires. The only change with the agreement was that the location of the live broadcast moved to Tenet's YouTube channel. INTCW never produced any content for Tenet Media. Never at any point did anyone other than I have full editorial control of the show, and the contents of the show are often apolitical. Examples include discussing spirituality, dating, and video games. The show is produced in its entirety by our local team without input from anyone external to the company. TCW is a separate company, not associated with TimCast.com or other properties. It exists solely for the production of the Culture War. That being said, we still don't know what is true, as these are only allegations. That's why I'm saying. Putin is a scumbag. Russia sucks donkey balls. And the journalists who wish to jump the gun, create their own narrative, or lie about what is currently going on, you can eat my Irish ass. So that's Tim Pool's response, right? Then Benny Johnson has also given a response as well. A statement on the leaked DOJ indictment today. A year ago, a media startup pitched my company to provide content as an independent contractor. Our lawyers negotiated a standard arm's length deal, which was later terminated. We are distributed by the allegations in today's indictment, which make clear that myself and other influencers were victim in this scheme. My lawyers will handle anyone who states or suggests otherwise. So they're stating they're victims and the whole nine yards. And I think that could very well be the case. right? And Lauren Chan, I think, is the one that they're claiming is the founder, and she's allegedly the one that knew who they were really dealing with. Again, this is allegedly. She's also a conservative YouTuber. Although, what's interesting about Lauren Chan is lately, she has been giving more support against Donald J. Trump, which is interesting. And by the way, Putin has come out and said he's, or his administration, I don't remember if it was him or his administration, but they have come out and said he's vouching for Kamala Harris, which is interesting because all of this propaganda, the whole time they're like, Trump and Russia. You know, interesting, right? Not only that, but there's one other thing that happened right after the announcement came about Tim Pool, Benny, Lauren Southern, and all of them. One announcement that is very important as well is this happened immediately after, right? And literally seconds before I came on air right now. And this is on Fox News. Hunter Biden intends to plead guilty on federal tax charges brought by special counsel David Weiss. God forbid you hear that story. They need a little bit of a distraction, don't they? Don't they? They absolutely do. Now, for the rest of this report, I am going to take it on over to RestrictedRepublic.com. For those of you who watch on RestrictedRepublic.com, you know exactly why. Please get there. Sign up right now. You can get it for $5 per month. That is. I know it's a hard economy right now, but it's less than a cup of coffee. It's less than a glass of beer now at a lot of places. Use the coupon code Lisa and the number 5. If you want to get down to the nitty-gritty and get my input and my honest input on this whole thing, then you need to get to RestrictedRepublic.com today and check it out. Check it out now. Subscribe. Now, get on over there. You're not going to want to miss the rest of this report. Anyhow, with that, I hope to see you over there. I'm Lisa Haven, signing out.